this video, I'm gonna be showing y'all how I start my box braids. And this is just a mannequin that I have. I have kind of silky. So these are the products that I'm gonna be using on it. Shonen Jump and some beeswax. When you're doing people that have silky hair, you probably wanna go with some beeswax. So I'm just gonna do like a medium size. These are just some old twists that I put on the head. I'm just gonna do one row just to show y'all how I grip and everything. Okay, so if you're doing this on a mannequin, your part is not gonna be perfect. Like how it's straight across, it's not gonna be perfect. So just do the best. And I say that this is probably about 4 braids, probably. Okay. When you're doing this on a regular person hair, you can use Shonen Gem. You can use Shonen Gem to clean your part and everything, but that's really unnecessary with her head. Hard it. You could do 3 if you don't want them so close together, or if you don't want them too full. But I'm gonna do 4. Yeah. I'm gonna grab my beeswax. I usually put it on the back of my hand, but I'm only doing 4 braids. So I'm gonna just take this and put it on there. This makes the hair more stiff when you have silky hair or fine hair like this. And I'm gonna also take some of my Shonen Gem and put it on there. Okay, now when I do my braids, I used to just like do it like whole like this, but you grip it better when you split it in half. It don't have to be evenly in half, but just split it in half like this. So I'm gonna take my hair, and there's 2 ways to that I can do it. So I'm gonna show you 2 ways. This is the way that I used to do it. I have this piece of hair. What I do is I take one of my fingers and I'll go through it, like split it in half, and I'll twist it a couple times like this. Twist it about 3 times. And now I'm gonna show you how I start. Okay, put this at the top and I got the top piece first. I got it and then all right, and then I grab the bottom piece like this. And I take it, and I tighten it up like that. And then I start the braid. As I'm braiding down, I always put like some Shonen Gem on it here and there. To keep the flyaway down so that when I go back and trim the braid, it's not that much to trim. Okay, so I continue to braid down, and once I get to the end, when I get there. Once I start feeling it getting skinny like this, I go ahead and knot it. And then boom. Just like you tie some thread. But I braid like this so that I know it's secure and it just looks way much neater to me. So this is how I used to do my braids. This is how I used to start them off, but I didn't really like that knot. Even though it looks okay, I didn't really like that knot. So let me show y'all how I do my braids now. I'm gonna show y'all how I do this one. I'm just gonna do the same thing that I did on the first braid. my beeswax and stuff. Okay, so I do the same thing that I did with the first one. I just split it in half, split it in two. So this is how I do the hair this time. So I literally split the hair in two. And I take this and I cross it over this. And I cross it over this piece. Like that. So now it's like this. And then I take this hand and I put it under here to grab these two pieces like this. And I turn around like this. So now you got this. Basically.
We just
create
the knot, basically.
Yeah, we just create the knot. I like this one because the knot looks better. So now this is one long. This is the one piece right here, and the other piece just hanging like that. And now just take this piece with these two hands. I look dumb.
Lift off the palm of these two. I'll laugh so hard.
And now I'm about to show y'all how I grip it this way. So now I have three even pieces. So then I do the same way. By taking the first part, I take the, okay, so. Okay, so what I do is I hold this piece right here. I take this piece and I move out the way kind of, like hold it like that. And then I grab the first piece and put it in to this hand where the other two pieces at right here. I put it into this hand. So I'll move it over there into this hand and I'll let that piece go. Now I'm finna grab it like I'm finna grip. So instead of me grabbing the bottom piece before I start like braiding, I go ahead and braid one time, literally like this. And I grab that piece and then I start right there. And then I grab the bottom piece. So I take this hand and I grab it and I put it into this hand. Like that. And then I start to braid. So this is when I tighten it up, I pull.
It's always circle. All
right, so as I'm gripping, I'm pulling to make sure that it's tight. That's how you get that grip.
That grip.
I'm gonna break down one more time before I turn my hands the other way to start braiding down. So.
This is a smaller knot, by the way.
Yeah, I like this knot because it's smaller. That's why I love this way right here. That's why I do it this way. So,
I'm gonna want that
bulky ball. So if y'all like this knot, go with it. If you like this knot,
let me know.
I'm with you, sis. All right, so I just repeat the same steps. So I'm repeating the same steps. Okay, so in this braid, I'm gonna show y'all how you can hide the hair. No matter if she got the color. So what you wanna do is, see that right there? You wanna take this and pull it out the way to go under the braiding hair. See how ain't no hair showing? So you just keep on braiding. I'm gonna take that a little bit and put it up under there. So when you do that in the beginning, the hair will automatically be falling underneath the weave part. So it's already in its place. So when you start braiding your regular way, I don't know if y'all do this, but it's how I start and it's how I finish, baby. Okay, so see her head hitting in the beginning and everything. So therefore, when you start, look at her piece of hair trying to hang out. So therefore, when you start braiding, it's already in its place. But once it get out of hand, you put it right back in its place. Last one. So y'all, this is how I start and grip my box braids. Now, 1, 2, 3. And these two look better because the hair is tucked away. Hopefully y'all have learned something. And this just looks so ugly to me. Like, I used to do it, but now it just looks so ugly. And these look way much better. And not them at the ends. So, if y'all like this video, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe and like. Comment for more videos that y'all would like to see me do. And more videos coming soon.